Hello friends, this is Kumar Pratyush and welcome to my channel Educhem Discovery. Friends, today we are going to learn about the Excel software that is inbuilt in the Microsoft packages. Now, we are very aware about Excel working, like it can help us to calculate some data in a very efficient and fast manner. Now friends, today we are going to learn about the application of sum function, sum if function. Now, what is the difference between sum function and sum if function? Like, if I want, I am writing a number 32, 43, 54. Now what I have to do, I want to sum these all three numbers. So what I will do, I will go in this, write first equal to sign. Now I will write sum. You can see that there are some other functions also, so I am choosing sum. I will open the bracket. What it is telling, that number 1, so now my number 1 is this, then a comma, so I will place a comma, number 2, so my number 2 is this, now again a comma, and then my number 3 is this. I will close the bracket and this is my summation. So it is very easy to calculate the summation of the number when it is given in a randomized form. But what if I have to use the if function, like sum if function? Now what is actually the sum if function says? If these are the three students, AVF, AA and LK. Now you can see that there were four choices, like A, B, C, D of the question. Question number A carries 2 marks. Question number B carries 2 marks, question number C carries 3.5 marks and question number D carries 3.5 marks. Now what I have to do here is, I have to calculate the summation of the numbers, like questions, like if a question, students all are optional. If all the questions are optional, then suppose AVF attempted A question and achieved 1 marks, but he didn't attempted the B question and he moved to the C question and he attempted 3 marks. He got 3 marks. Okay. In the similar pattern, AA attempted the B question and he achieved 2 out of 2, but D attempted. AA attempted the D question and just got the 2 marks. Okay. Now, LKA attempted A and got 0 marks, or you can say 1 marks. Now, he also attempted B question and he got 2 marks. Now, this is the variable. This is the discrete variable. You can see that AVF named student attempted A and C question, AA attempted B and D question, LKA attempted 1 A and B question. Now, if I insert one of the column here, so this is a complete total. So what I have to do, I shown you right now, I will write sum bracket. What I have to do, I have to just select this one. So what I will do, this first we have to write equal to sum bracket. Now you can see that these three cells will be summed up and data will be achieved. Now you can see the formula is equal to sum C5 is to F5. That means if I click on this cell, you can see that this is telling C5 cell and F5 cell all are simultaneously added up. But what if I want that how this marks achieved is how is achieved out of how much marks? Because if he has attempted A question, the total marks carrying was 2 marks, and B question it was carrying 2 marks, 3 question, C question then 3.5, and D then 3.5. So he has attempted only 2 questions. What is the percentage of his marks achieved? Again, it is a problem. So in this case, what we are going to use, we are going to use the if function. Now, I want to calculate the marks if the student have achieved a question. He has attended a question, then we have to add this so that I will get the total marks out of which he achieved this mark. What I will do, equal to, I will write sum. Now I will also write if. Now this is a condition, right? Now I will open the bracket. What is it is telling? It is telling that range. So what is my range of calculation? So my range of calculation is I want to sum this. So these cells will be summed up now, comma, criteria. What is the criteria? So for criteria, I am opening a bracket, writing a greater than sign and zero. And again, I am closing the bracket. So this is my criteria, and again a comma. So this is my criteria. If the number of C5 and F5, C5 to F5 are greater than 0, then these all numbers will be summed up. Now what will be summed up? So I will write the sum range is this. You can see I have just placed the shift arrow and shift plus right arrow. So now I am closing the bracket. So what the formula we achieved? If the number that is 1, 0, 3, 0 is greater than 0, then cell number C3 to CF3 will be added up. So what is the data I got? Like the ABF has attempted only A question, C has attempted only, ABF has also attempted the C question. The marks that A question was carrying was 2, and another marks that it was carrying was 3.5. That means 3.5 plus 2 is 5.5. Now it is a very small data where I am extracting this value. You can use this function for n number of calculations also. Now again, I want to calculate out of this 5.5, how much marks did he score? So what will we, I will use, here we have already calculated it, but again we are going to calculate using if function. What was the formula? Sum if, now opening the bracket. Now what will be the range of mine? It will be 2 to 3.5, comma, criteria will be, my criteria is if the number is greater than 0, then again sum range, add up this. Bracket is closed and answer is 4. You can see that the sum total is similar. Now if I want to calculate the percentage, I can easily calculate equal to bracket open, this I5 divided by the total marks, bracket close, into 100. So we can calculate like the percentage of marks scored in individual question is 72.72727. So we can easily calculate these data, but if I want to copy the same formula in the other cell, the value comes 0. Everyone will be shocked. Why? Again, I am copying the same formula by drag and drop option. Again, the value is 0. This should be not the case. But what is the problem with the formula is, in this you can see that if the C5 and 2F5 is greater than 0, then we have to add C3 and F3. This cell is always common and for the all the variables. So what I will do, you can see that in this case it became 4, so I will write again 3 and again 3. But is it feasible for me for working on every function and correcting it? So no. So I will use the dollar sign. C$3, C$3, F$3. So what does it help us with? It will lock this cell for all the calculation, and the variable will change. C5 will change to C6, and only this variable is going to change. Now you can see same 2 plus 3.5, and you can see that now I am copying it, I am getting the answer. So now what I will do, again I will put a dollar sign. So where I have to put a dollar sign, I will change this variable. I have to put a variable sign in, I have to lock it. Now you can see that I got the answer, and again I got the again answer. So this is how you can use the sum and SUMIF function. I hope so you like this. If you have any doubt and any, if you want to comment on this, you can freely comment. I will be hoping for you. Thank you, and please join our channel. I will add more details about it, and we will learn more. We will, in my next video, you are going to see how we can count the variables by using the if function, like countif function. Thank you.